Antiques Roadshow viewers were treated to a brand new installment of the show filmed at the Royal Botanic Garden in Edinburgh. Expert Richard Price was tasked with evaluating a Rolex and left the owner stunned by its value when he uncovered a rare feature of the watch on the BBC show. Richard began, "Whenever I see a Rolex of this type, I have to ask you, are you a professional diver?" The guest confirmed he wasn't before Richard added, "So what tempted you to buy a professional diver's watch?" "Well, I was aware that Rolexes made the best watches and my brother-in-law, who's now passed away, had a submariner," he answered. He said, "If you're going to buy one, buy the Sea Dweller." The expert explained, "This particular one is all described in your original invoice, so you bought it new, January 82. "Read more," Richard began, "whenever I see a Rolex of this type, I have to ask you, are you a professional diver?" The guest confirmed he wasn't before Richard added, "So what tempted you to buy a professional diver's watch?" "Well, I was aware that Rolexes made the best watches and my brother-in-law, who's now passed away, had a submariner," he answered. He said, "If you're going to buy one, buy the Sea Dweller." The expert explained, "This particular one is all described in your original invoice, so you bought it new, January 82. And this is the iconic 1665, Richard continued. "You mentioned submariner, and initially it had in red writing Sea Dweller and submariner on the dial. This one is the last in a series of what collectors refer to as the Great White, for obvious reasons, because it's got the white writing, not the red. Things to look at for the Great White: it's still got the very small helium escape valve, tiny compared to the later model. Do you understand why they needed that? The owner suggested it was to release pressure when divers return to the surface." Richard said, "Absolutely right, because minute particles of helium gas would get in through the case when they were down low in a chamber or whatever. Then when they ascended, the gas would try to literally push the glass out of the watch, so that valve let out the helium as they decompressed. Have you ever had it cleaned and overhauled by anybody, or is this pretty much the original condition?" "Can't remember, because it's been lying in a drawer for 30 years," the guest admitted. "Well, the only thing I can fault it on really is the fact that the glass is very scratched." "What happened there?" Richard asked. "I was cycling with my daughter and I was going downhill too fast, came off and it cut on the gravel," the owner explained. "I ended up in hospital for a week with a punctured lung. It survived and so did I." Richard remarked, "Wow, you're here looking very well to me. This is what we call the full set, pretty much, your bill of sale. I noticed you've got a discount, cash discount £34, that was a useful sum off, because the list price £403 was quite a chunk of money, wasn't it? So you've not done too badly, actually. People are asking silly money for them, but I reckon for you a mid-market price of £18,000 to £20,000 would be fair," Richard revealed. "Unbelievable," the owner replied before Richard added, "Do you know what I'd do if I was you? I'd take off that quartz that you're wearing and wear this for a little bit." "I might do," he responded. "That's amazing, I am absolutely staggered." He later added, "Well, I watch Antiques Roadshow, I never miss it, and I've seen Rolexes coming on, so I thought it'd be worth a fair amount, but that just amazed me." Antiques Roadshow continues on BBC One on Sunday at 7 p.m.